Alright, so Hitman, fresh home. Let me know a little details about, you know, you being incarcerated.
I caught a case in 2012, like the beginning of that bitch. Back then, I wasn't really smart enough to, you know the system or how to handle the situation. So I ended up signing for probation. You know what I'm saying? I ended up fucking up on the probation. And that's what ended up me, you know what I'm saying, I do a little time. I really didn't tell nobody, you know what I'm saying? I really kept it under the wraps, you know what I'm saying? My squad knew, of course, but really kept that shit under the wraps because, you know, that ain't the image we need trying to portray. Like, right. I think stay in jail a lot, like, which we're really doing the case of just that one case that I was doing, like, little days for violating and shit like that.
Right.
And then I violated, revoked my probation.
Right.
A little time, then, yeah.
For sure, so you was on the run?
Yeah.
How long was you on the run for?
I ran for the whole 2014, I ran. Right. Until, like, well, let's say, the end of 2013, like October, all the way to the summer, the day the list came out. The day you put the list out is the day I went in.
Right, now, we're gonna touch on the list later. People said it was a coincidence because I put that you was on a run on the list, yeah. And then you got locked up. I heard people were kind of upset that I had put that on there. I don't know. Yeah. Explain that. Like, do you think it was crazy. A coincidence?
Man, I mean, I thought a bunch of shit. You know what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, it was like, damn. You know what I'm saying? Like, I still remember this shit like it was yesterday. So, nigga called me. He's like, yo, bro. Nigga say you Gucci Man Dallas, bro. You got legal issues and shit. I'm like, yeah. I'm like, god damn, how the fuck do they even know this shit in the first place? So I'm like, whatever, I'ma just deny that shit. You know what I'm saying? So when I posted the pic, you know what I'm saying, shouting y'all out, I was like, no legal issues or whatever with you whoop.
Same. See, I didn't think that was something that you were hiding. Cause you know a lot of artists take pride in that. Like, yeah. You know, I've been to jail 5-6 times.
I wasn't necessarily hiding that. I was necessarily trying to hide. I was on the run, not that I was going to violate and being in jail and shit like that. I don't give a fuck about that, but
for sure.
Just me being on the run.
So how did you get caught?
Shit, I got pulled over. Then got pulled over and shit. I gave him a fake name, but that shit. But no, that shit, it didn't go through. I had some papers and shit in my car. I actually went one day in my car, my sister's car. I don't know how the fuck she had some shit with my name on in that bitch. But pulled that shit up, pictures in there. I ain't had no idea nothing on me like that, so giving a fake name. I done that shit like 3 times though. That's the thing. So I was like, hope this shit work. But like,
now how was the transition? You know, You was putting out videos once a week, you know, very consistent. You was putting out videos once a week, you know, being very, you know, consistent. How was going to jail? Like, how was the feeling?
Tell you the truth, when I got caught, I was like, real like, fuck, you know what I'm saying? Because no matter how much money I try to put up, no matter what I try to do to get up out this shit, like, I can't leave this hoe for another at least 6 months. You know what I'm saying? Like, that was just in the front of my head, like, fuck. I can't get out of this hoe with no bail, no nothing. I can't even get $1 million bail if I wanted it. You know what I'm saying? They just weren't having that shit. You know what I'm saying? So I was just like, fuck, I can't do shit. I'm standing still. I'm on the phone, like, hey, let's try to do this, let's do that, let's do this, do that. And I really was just, you know what I'm saying, trying to make moves from inside that hoe. Really what I was trying to do, but it was... Couldn't work, couldn't do nothing. You know what I'm saying? All you could do really is the phone. And that ain't shit.
Right. Now, I listen to a lot of your music, and you rap about jugging, finessing, catching plays, running plays. Now, that's like the thing in Dallas. Like, a lot of rappers in Dallas, outside of y'all group, Coalition,
yeah.
A lot of rappers rap about catching plays, running plays.
Right.
Was that something that y'all started?
Of course.
The whole jug music. What jugging is now to the D, you know what I'm saying? That shit started on Hitman Absolution.
I mean, like, I started rapping about jugging, like, the summer of 2013. Like, the 100 mode that I got with Peso and the video, all that shit that we did, that been done. You know what I'm saying? And then I dropped that mixtape, Juug Music, really just, I ain't gonna say created a whole nother lane, but like, it ain't like trap music. You know what I'm saying? It's like, Juug Music is a way of, your way of getting money that it's real life shit. All I can do is rap about what I do or what goes on every day. You know what I'm saying? Like, just like if you listen to Hitman Solution, you can tell I was in trouble with the law if you listen to it.
It's a new Juug, and it's a new young nigga hustle. You know what I'm saying? Trapping it, you know what I'm saying? Everybody trap before, you know what I'm saying? That's a new young nigga hustle is Juug.
Now some people may ask, what exactly is that? Is there a depth, like, what is it? Is it crack?
It's a way to get money.
Like, does it have anything to do with drugs, or is it always illegal?
It's some illegal, some not illegal, but it ain't got nothing to do with drugs, I can tell you that. Some people might, like, I know, like when I first heard Juug, like, it was Gucci Man, like, 2012, he was saying, "Bustin' Juug." I know, we all know, he said he the trap guy or whatever, so it might mean Juug, drugs to them, you know what I'm saying? But when we started, it was like, yo, whatever, however your hustle, you make money, you know what I'm saying? It's a Juug, everything is a Juug, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? A nigga, anybody that can listen to it, you can reference trap in it. Same time, you know what I'm saying? Trap rips just go hand in hand with Juug. It's really the same type of shit.
Really the same shit, it's just.
A hustle is a hustle, you know what I'm saying? Hey, you can be illegal. So long as you get money, you provide.
Right. So who's all in y'all group? Is it just y'all two as far as the rappers go?
DMV is, as far as rappers, yeah, basically me and Rick, you know, but we got DJs, you know, Cal Banks and producers, T Wool. And all us, and we got coalitions and people we fuck with, like ONT. I'm part of ONT too, with Pace on them. We fuck with everybody around the city. You know what I'm saying?
I produce too.
So we really got everything in the camp, you know what I'm saying?
So what's next?
Shit, got a lot of shit, bro. I can sit here and go down a page, you know what I'm saying? I'll just tell you, just look out, bro. That's really all I can tell you, bro.
No slowing down.
Just look out, bro.
2015, no, ain't no slowing down. We're gonna master goods.
For sure. So, if y'all had to pick a few artists in the city who y'all got your eyes on, you know, who y'all would work with, what's some artists in the city that you like to work with?
I just knocked out a feature for Jason Lyric. I've been wanting to work with him. You know what I'm saying? I did that for him. Sriracha Boys, Uno Losa, that's my homie. Really anybody, to tell you the truth. I just really want to see it, to be honest, at the end of the day.